Hi there, welcome to my gaming blogs. Over the past 10 years, I have been rebuilding and updating my racing simulator over and over again. Today, I finalized the last iteration of features I added to it, and would like to share this process with you all. Currently, my racing simulator implements a series of interesting features. It has a direct drive wheel, which can pick up even the slightest imperfections on the asphalt. It has a vibration system composed of two bass shakers that are configured to simulate variations on the car suspension. They pick up road surface changes, for example, when passing through a curb, or when I lock the wheels under heavy braking. It also has a wind simulator that modulates the fan speed based on the car speed. All of that is currently controlled by a custom-made operation box, which gives me direct access to each of these features. All of these features are installed in an aluminium frame, which is enclosed on my own secret entrance. Besides being a cool feature for my game room, it helps me a lot with the immersion when I'm racing. With my current setup, I can have a very good feedback on the car, by feeling when the brakes lock, or by perceiving very quickly when the rear snaps, so I can correct it. One feature that's missing, and might help a lot in making consistent laps, and will make the simulator much more interesting to drive, is a G-Force simulator. The best way to make a G-Force simulator is to install a full motion platform, which will allow the movement of the car's suspension to be transferred directly to the simulator. This is a very expensive update, and I honestly do not have the space to do it right now. The second best way to create a G-Force simulator is to build a belt tensioner system. The idea is relatively simple. By having access to the car's speed and movement direction, we can calculate the G-forces horizontal and lateral. These forces can be translated to a pair of servo motors that will tension the seatbelt. This way, when there is a high G-force, the seatbelt will make pressure and will push me towards the seat. By controlling each belt individually, we can also represent lateral G-forces. The project is relatively simple, and I had a lot of help from a friend. He did this build before me for his own simulator and provided me with most of the design and electronic solutions for it. As I mentioned, the main feature of this project are two servo motors that will be connected to the endpoint of the seatbelt. Once I accelerate or brake, the motors tension the seatbelt, which push me towards the seat. To control the motors, a simple circuit is needed. Each servo motor needs around 8 volts of power and are controlled by a PWM signal, which regulates the motor position. The electronics part of this project is relatively easy. I need two servo motors, a 12-volt power supply, and two buck converters that will step down the 12 volt of power to the 8 volts needed by each motor. From the motor side, everything will be controlled by an Arduino Uno, which will receive a new motor position from the computer and send it to the motors using a PWM port. To mount the motors on my chassis, I needed to print the servo mounts. To plug the motors into the seatbelts, a custom-made adapter was also necessary. They use a simple zip tie to connect the servo to the seatbelts. A custom-made control box was also designed, and all the electronic parts were cozily put inside. With everything ready, the setup was quite easy. To get the telemetry from the racing simulator, I'm using the SimHub software. It receives telemetry from a series of simulators and racing games, and allows the implementation of plugins that can parse and send this data to different devices, including the G-Force simulator. I need to get the G-Force's parameters from SimHub, convert them into motor tension, and send them to the Arduino, which then must send this to the motors using the PWM ports. On SimHub, I'm using two plugins. First, to receive the data from the simulators, I'm using a modified ShakeIt Motors plugin. This plugin reads specific telemetry from a racing simulator and processes it by applying filters and signal clipping. This modified version of the Shake It Motors plugin parses the G-forces and translates them into three attributes: acceleration, deceleration, and lateral G-forces. Second, we need to send this information to the Arduino, and for that I'm using the custom serial device plugin. It allows me to receive the attributes from the Shake It Motors plugin and send them to the Arduino via serial connection. On both the Shake It plugin and the custom serial plugin, we can fine-tune the parameters for the motor, which helps a lot with the testing and fine-tuning of the belt tensioners. Finally, we need to tell the Arduino to receive the information from SimHub and send the PWM signals to the motors. This is done by uploading into the Arduino a custom sketch. All the code I'm using was modified from the original version provided by Black & Blue on GitHub, and I'm letting his own GitHub page linked in the video description. I am also adding a link to my own GitHub page for this project, which contains all the instructions on how to set up this specific belt tensioner system. Once everything is set, time to test it. And that's all from my side today. I hope you enjoyed the video and see you all next time.